It's been quite some time since we have last spoken. Where are we now? I found you sitting concave at the bottom of a well, dejected, overripe, and sun-dried. Dear one, what has this all come down to? They say that one cannot speak frankly about pains until they are no longer enduring it. So come down to the river for a while. The water runs silly. Don't speak. There's no need to say anything pretty. You can crawl if you need to. You can mourn if you must. Stay with me. Drag your tired, angry mind kicking and screaming across this godless universe. Feel with your warm, red hand the life that rushes angry, wretchedly through your flesh. Stroke your temples with soft spots that fail like the soundless motion of birds flying arrow-like back home. Gather up the rough drafts of every unfinished love letter you have left scattered like autumn leaves on your lap and burn them. Torch the half-filled pages in a roaring iron furnace that sits restlessly in the back of your throat. Use the new warmth to shout and the wild, immaculate light to dance. Pick up a pen. Write with all your might. Write I 10 times. Write love 50 times. Write you once. Write it again. Sing it. Orchestrated with every romance language you know, dear one. I know you feared that I will not return, but here I am, the breath that inflates your lungs. I am the kind, patient words. I'm so proud of you. That you saw once or twice, scampering across the field of your mind. Now this will not last, you and I now, but like ghosts in the nighttime, I will exist in shadow when you are afraid. Beckon toward me when the hollow wind blows wretchedly in your cathedral ribcage. Find me, dear one, in the music you promised yourself to write someday soon. To put it frankly, there are times I wonder if the depression has made its home inside of you. The curtains yanked shut, doors rusted at the hinge, unopened, but foolishly it does not know that the very home it has burrowed in is mosaic, diamond, and stone. It does not know that the pain is a messenger, not a recipient, and that only if you listen closely do you reap its beauty. I'm here to say, to reteach you how to motion your toddling, beautiful mind up an unfinished staircase. Tell me, what music do you hear in your mind when you begin to forgive the viscous silence? Tell me, dear one, what does it sing? Love, it cries in the dust and harmony. Pride, it bangs and clangs in a 10-finger orchestra. Hope, it whispers almost silently into the carousel of the world.